listening to consumers is something that feels very simple, but brands don't do it. And that was my vision for, you know, why is customer support the person in the corner of the office with the old laptop being told to go at the front lines and fight for the company when nobody even knows what's going on or what they're doing and everyone else is focused on something else. So my vision back then is like, you know, we're spending so much money on every part of the company other than support. Support is always outsourced. Support is always the corner of the office. Nobody knows what's going on. They just know these people are answering emails. And I spent the next 4 years at that brand for just doing every single part of a startup, right? It's like I touched every part of the company other than finance, and learned that that was, you know, we ship thousands of suitcases to 64 countries, and operations logistics was super interesting to me. But what I realized is that the most underutilized part of the business at startups today, especially in CPG and direct to consumer, is support. Right, it's like brands start off and they get super excited with the growth and they invest more and more money in growth, and growth is very binary, right? You spend money, you make money, for the most part. And experience is like it feels like a cost center. So that was my real excitement around experience. So then, you know, COVID hit, luggage was not a hot commodity, and decided that I was, you know, with COVID, you know, customer experience was even more important. You know, delays were popping up, consumers were furious and short-tempered, and they wanted things their way, which makes sense, right? So that was kind of my time where I was like, I'm gonna go all in on experience and support. And kind of when I came across Olipop, you know, I talk about this a lot as far as a brand, you know, you can have your greatest vision in the world. And I'm sure everyone on this call has had a great vision, and you go work at a brand and you're doing something entirely different, right? So finding a company that doesn't stifle your vision, but actually lifts up your vision and puts it on a pedestal and invests money into it is a dream for any employee. That's kind of how I came across Olipop. I was introduced by a friend, and in chatting with David and Steven and a couple of others on the team for the first 30 minutes, these people were like, yeah, we love your vision. If you come here, you take it, you run with it. And the last year plus has been insane, right? Like Olipop as a business has grown like 600% in 2020. And just going from 500 stores to 6,000 stores, and, you know, e-commerce becoming a massive part of the business, I've had the opportunity to kind of do all different kind of fun things on experience. But I think that the most fun part was that we're bringing, you know, customer experience to the front of the conversation again, and viewing it in the lens of retention, which I'm sure we can hop in a little bit more about. And even in the lens of subscription, how does that tie into experience, and just viewing every single part of the business that way.